Now, when I say I hate the hunting horn, I don't mean that I hate the core of the weapon or what it's supposed to be. I hate what they did to it. I hate that they stripped it of its personality and reduced it to a weapon that you whip out and put right away like a stranger in the streets with a trench coat. It has some absolutely fantastic value and can be a game changer, don't get me wrong. It's extremely powerful and effective, I just don't love the way they went about it. And we even had something kind of similar happen in the mainline series. I'm not some angry boomer trying to reclaim some era that I thought was the golden age. I just miss my horn as it used to be, and I'm worried that I'm never going to get to see it again. When it comes to the hunting horn in the story series, it was easily my most played weapon in stories 1, but now in stories 2, I'm a bit hesitant to use it because it's kind of boring and doesn't really feel gratifying to use. I loved ripping off the acid jazz song on the Garuga horn to bring down the monster's defenses, and I loved throwing up Harmonious Duet to really ramp up the kinship gauge, but I had to earn those things. I wasn't able to just pick a song and spend some kinship to unleash a very potent song just like that. There was plenty of different songs with different note combinations with varying effects that made you switch up your horns depending on the situation. When you look at the horns in stories 2, the only thing that really is unique about the horns are the looks. They feel a lot more interchangeable to me this time. Streamlining can definitely be a good thing, but you do have pros and cons to doing so. Unfortunately, this really took out my desire to use the weapon as much as I normally would. Now, again, don't get me wrong, this isn't me saying that my opinion on the changes or the way they make me feel about the weapon should mean more or less than any other person, but I do feel like I'm not in the minority in this feeling. The effectiveness of the weapon has definitely had a huge uptick, but in doing so, they had to sacrifice the fun, strategy, and gratification of achieving that effectiveness. So, just to give a quick example as to how the hunting horn worked in Stories 1, let me play out a quick sequence. To play a song, you needed to use a specific sequence of notes to activate the song and gain the effects. So to play Empowering Beat, we have to use a technical attack followed by a speed attack, and then after we play that final necessary power note, our song will play, and in this case, our song basically gives us a free extra attack, almost like an encore, and has the chance to increase our own attack. Do you already see how it feels more like what the hunting horn is, or I guess was? It always felt so good when you found a way to perfectly implement the song and get it off, especially if you could land a head-to-head win or double attack in the midst of pulling off those notes. In a lot of cases, you also had simpler songs that would be able to play songs with two of the same notes or the same attacks being picked. So you could still pick a horn that would be the best matchup with the monster's tendencies while benefiting from the buffs the songs would give you or the debuffs it would give the monster. I know people's immediate reaction to this kind of combo system being used is that PvP would be a dumpster fire, but the scenario isn't as simple as they might make it sound. The theory is that people would know the notes that are required for each song and then be able to preemptively plan what attacks you were going to do and how they should respond. I disagree with this theory. I absolutely see the logic in it, but I don't see it playing out this way. One of the things that we have to remember is that if a player uses the hunting horn, they're an absolute Chad, so it would not be so easy to predict their moves. Now let's take a look at this situation. The Deora horn has a song called Harmonious Duet that has your kinship gauge filled 1.5 times faster. You play it by using 3 power attacks in a row. So let's say you're the Gypsyros and the Cephadrome in this situation. What do you do? Do you commit your rider or monster to the opposing rider to make sure you interrupt the song? Well, then you would risk the Gold Rathian ripping off some devastating attack. So then you would commit your monster and rider to do a double attack on the Gold Rathian to keep it from unleashing that fire nuke. But then the song gets played and the enemy rider and Gold Rathian have increased kinship to rip off stronger attacks more frequently. Okay, but you're gonna make the big brain play and use your monster to interrupt the song on a head-to-head with the rider since you know Harmonious Duet requires one more power attack. But the enemy rider figured you were going to try and interrupt that last note, so they go with a technical attack on the bluff and get a head-to-head win on you immediately. It could play out in so many different ways, and that's just talking about one song. Now, Mama Handy always told me, if you come to me with a problem, you better come with a solution as well. My solution would be a little blending of the two systems. You could have song sets that were spread across the different horns that you could just play right off the bat with Kinship, maybe call them quick plays or something. After that is where we bring in the heavier hitters, things like All Ailments Negated, Evasion Riffs, Awakening, and Bloodsuck. To play these songs, you'll have to go through the old combo system of playing songs. Now, if they want this to be simple, two-note combos or three-note combos, that would be up to them and dependent on the strength of the song's effect. Implementing this would give high risk and high reward. The reward would obviously be that you get a potent buff or debuff on the enemy, but also, you would be getting these at zero kinship cost, all while simultaneously building up your kinship. The risk, of course, is that if you end up getting caught mid-combo, you've basically wasted those attacks and have to start right back from the beginning. I would definitely like to see some more unique songs thrown in there as well. High risk, high reward, strategic gameplay, and gratification when you pull off these stronger, more potent songs. And how about getting debuffs back in the first place? There's so much potential for debuffing with all of the things that have been added to stories too. Simple things like bringing down non-elemental or elemental defenses, lowering attack, and skill sealing. How in the nine hells does Gunlance have skill seal potential, but not the Hunting Horn? Hunting Horn should be the buffing king, and I'm talking buffing and debuffing, but they only have any kind of access to the first. Even just tossing in another song set that did debuffing would be a great addition. And for those of you looking to the PvP side of things, how great would it be to have a horn that could take away buffs like Pump Up and Dragon Surge? You look at what it takes to get the most out of each weapon, and there's a pretty big difference when you talk about fun, engagement, etc. It's pretty easy for me to pick out what weapon I would say is the most fun and engaging. It's for sure the Gunlance. But seriously, let's take a look and kind of compare the different weapons. You have somewhat of the same problem as you do with the Hunting Horde with Sword and Shield. There's no real mechanic to it, really. You just build up kinship, and that's the long and short of it. But what sets it above the Hunting Horn and engagement is the fact that you have a slew of things that you can do. If you're getting bombarded with attacks, you can take a guard stance and drastically reduce damage, and even heal that damage back and then some if you have guard heal on you. But let's take that a step further. You can even turn into a Daimyo Hermitar and take a counter stance, hitting back immediately after an enemy hits you. And even when you get a topple on the monster, you have a move you can rip off that would do solid damage and can crit with slash kinship attacks. What Hunting Horn attack are you going to do to get that big chunky damage while a monster is down? You're gonna pick a normal speed, technique, or power attack. Or you're going to switch to another weapon, but that's the life of the Hunting Horn. This big behemoth has a mechanic that ties in perfectly with the mainline series. You have wide-reaching hits that can clap at every monster standing against you, chunky hits that help you dispatch single targets, and all of these moves are accessible through a charge mechanic. You have moves that increase your charge and ones that require charges to use. It's fun and engaging. When you see a monster get toppled knowing you have a single charge, ready to rip off a charge slash, you start salivating at the mouth for the damage you're about to do. But more importantly, you work towards getting that move by getting a charge stored in your pocket so it feels that much better to actually pull off. And not to mention that it can also guard as well. So the bow is a status inflicting master. You have a charge mechanic that takes your turn, and in return, you get to fire off a more potent arrow if you so choose to shoot a status inflicting arrow, or you can fire off some of the arrows that are specifically unlocked through this charge mechanic. You can rip off shots that are better at breaking parts, do more damage, or even hit multiple opponents through your spread shot or arc shots. The versatility of it all. Coatings alone give you such an incentive to switch up your bows. The different combinations of the charge shots and status arrows give you a wide choice for your arsenal. My god, they really went balls to the wall with this one. You have awesome head-to-head options in the form of shelling. These options give you obscene amounts of kinship. There are times where I'll purposely go out on hunts without a buddy, just so there's more of a chance that I'll be targeted by the monster. And when you get to the point where that kinship gauge is filled up, you even have multiple options at that stage. You can hop on your monster and rip off their kinship attack, or you can use the ultimately badass Wyvern's Fire and hit every monster in sight. But we're not done there. The Gunlance can debuff the monster. You can break out the power, tech, or speed seal to put the monster in a further dilapidated state. Oh, and you know how you can guard with the Gunlance? Well, you can turn into a knight in shining armor and literally give another member the ability to guard by using Protect and taking the hit for them. This weapon was done immaculately. Now we come to the Cheech to the Hunting Horn's Chong, its blunt brother, the Hammer. Like the Greatsword, it has a charge mechanic to give you that fun, engaging, and gratifying play. It differs from the Greatsword, but still holds true to the mainline feel. You gain charges by winning head-to-head engagements. Each charge that you get opens up different attacks. And the Hammer has even more versatility. You can do different single-target attacks, or attacks that will hit the full roster of enemies. The animations they use for each attack is perfect, and is a tribute to the mainline series' combat. But we're not done with this weapon yet. You can even use chaser moves with different status ailments. Each Hammer has two different status ailments that they can chase down and do more damage. There's even a regular and plus option for you to have even more versatility. If you know that status is about to wear off, you can consume it and do some chunky damage in return. So I hope you can see now why I'm kind of miffed about the Hunting Horn and the level of fun and engagement you can have with it. It doesn't feel gratifying when you pull off that evasion riff or the awakening song that greatly buffs your attack, defense, and crit rate. You literally just spend some kinship, play the song, and 9 chances out of 10, switch to another weapon. Honestly, the only real incentive to keep the horn out is if blunt damage is the weak point on the part you're trying to break. Now, I don't make this video with any kind of happiness or pleasure, but it's just how I feel, or we feel, because I'm sure I'm not the only one. And it probably is just me screaming into the void, and we won't see any kind of result from it, but that's okay. Just like it's okay that I don't really use the weapon much anymore when I previously used it a shit ton. I might be sad for myself, but I'm happy that the changes resonated with other people and gave them a step in the right direction of doing more than just damage, damage, damage. The changes weren't for me, and they don't have to be every time. I'm the type of person who enjoys a variety of weapons, so it's not like the game is absolutely lost to me or that I won't ever play it again. In fact, I already have over 200 hours in Stories 2. It feels very similar to the fact that I very rarely, if ever, use Hunting Horn and Rise. But that, my friends, is the topic for another day and another video. But that's gonna be it for this one. I'm not saying you're wrong if you still use the Hunting Horn, or even if you go as far to enjoy using the new Hunting Horn. I'm just saying that it's not the same weapon I loved, and that's okay. If you liked the video, let me know with that thumbs up or even that thumbs down. Do you like the new Hunting Horn in Stories 2? Let me know in the comments below. Subscribe and hit that bell for more Monster Hunter content. Have a good night, happy hunting, and I will see you guys in the next video.